This is Sanket here from Coding Blocks, and today we are going to discuss a new pattern matching algorithm, that is the KMP algorithm. So what is the pattern matching problem? The problem says that we have been given a string and a pattern, and we have to find all the occurrences of the given pattern in the given string. So we already have learned about the Rabin-Karp algorithm and the brute force algorithm, that is the naive algorithm, for the pattern matching problem, and in this video we are going to discuss the KMP algorithm. So the KMP algorithm is slight modification and a very large improvement over the brute force algorithm, which was discussed earlier. So in the brute force algorithm, what we were doing is just every time recomputing whenever we got a mismatch in the pattern and the string. So let us just see this example. So the given string is A B A B C X A B C X A B X A. Okay, and the given pattern is A B C X A B X. Okay, so this is the given string and the given pattern. So suppose we were applying the brute force approach for the pattern matching problem, then we would have started our I pointer from here, and we will be taking a J pointer from here, and then we will see if these two characters are matching. So here you can see these two are matching, so we will increment I, and now I will be pointing here and J will be pointing here, and here you can see these two are also matching, then I will be incremented to value 2 and J will also be incremented to value 2 if we are starting I with 0 and J with 0. So now I is pointing to the second character and J is also pointing to the second character. But here you can see this is a mismatch. This is a mismatch. So in the brute force algorithm, what we were doing is restart the whole algorithm from J is equals to 0 and from I is equals to 1. Initially we started with I is equals to 0 and J is equals to 0, and now after having a mismatch we will be starting from I is equals to 1 to J is equals to 0. Okay, now here you can see these two are again a mismatch, so we will again increment I. So now I will be pointing to the second index. Here you can see these two are match, so we will increment both I and J, and I is pointing to the third index and J is pointing to the first index, and here you can see this is again a mismatch. So now we will again update the value of J to 0 and we will start the I from third index. So now here you can see this is a match. The next character is also a match. This one is a match. This is also a match. Same goes for here. Same here. But now here you can see the last character X is not matching with the character C. So this is a mismatch again. So here you can see we got a mismatch. So the pattern is not starting from I is equals to third index. So now we will again start with J is equals to 0 and I is equals to 4. We will be starting with I is equals to 4. And again we will match if the character at I and the character at J are matching. So these are not matching, so again we will increment I. So I will be pointing to the next character. So again this will be a mismatch, this will be a mismatch. Okay, so now I will be pointing here. So I will point here. So here you can see these two characters are match, these two are also a match, and these four are also a match. So we found the pattern using the naive algorithm. See in the brute force approach that we just applied, every time when we are getting a mismatch, then we are initiating the value of J again to 0 and initiating the value of I to plus 1 to the last value of I. So this is quite a very expensive algorithm in terms of time complexity, because the time complexity of the following algorithm is big O of n into m, where n is the length of string and m is the length of the pattern. M is the length of pattern. Okay, So now, what KMP algorithm will do, KMP algorithm will make sure that we are not recomputing any character that we have already computed. That is, we will be cut-shorting some of the iterations that we are repeating in the brute force approach. So in the KMP algorithm, we will make sure that we are not recomputing any of the iterations that we have already done. So let me just rub this. Okay. So in KMP algorithm, we will make sure that there is no recomputation occurring. So to avoid the recomputation, what we will do is prepare a reset table. So in the reset table, what we will do is at every index, we will store that what is the length of longest suffix present till now, which is also present as a prefix, which is also present as a prefix in the pattern. So we discussed quite a few things here. So let me just repeat it. So what we are going to do is we just prepare a mapping, and we will call this mapping a reset table. So this reset table will be an array, and at every index we are going to store what is the length of the longest suffix possible till now, which is also present as a prefix in the pattern. So the longest suffix in the pattern, which is also present as a prefix in the pattern, we will store the length of that suffix at every corresponding index. So suppose this is the given pattern to us. So let me just draw the reset table, and we will discuss the algorithm on how to develop the reset table. Okay, so this will be our reset table. Okay, so initially what we will do is just map our characters. So the 0th index will be giving a value corresponding to A. The first will be for B, then C, X, A, B, and then X. And the corresponding indexes are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, so now initially what we will do is just initialize the 0th index with value minus 1. And you will see by with time that why we have initialized the value of the first index as minus 1. So now what we are going to do is iterate over this corresponding array, and we will keep two pointers. So what we are going to do is keep two pointers, I and J. Okay, so let me just keep the pointers at as I is equals to 0 and J is equals to minus 1. So initially I will be pointing here, I will be pointing here, and J will be having the value minus 1. So I equal to 0 and J is equals to minus 1. Then what we are going to do is iterate till the condition that while I is less than the pattern length, we are going to do some task. So what we are going to do is just first check. So we will first check that if the current character at I and the current character at J are equal or not. If they are equal, then what we will do is just increment the value of I and J and store the value of J at the index I in the reset table. And if they are not equal, so if they are not equal, then what we will do is just reset the value of J. Let us see how we are going to do that. So we are going to check. So how we will check? We will do it like while j is greater than or equal to 0 and the pattern at I is not equal to pattern at j, till this condition is satisfied, we are going to do something. So what we are going to do is just reset the value of j as j is equals to reset of j. So I guess in the first being you would not be able to recognize why I have put this logic, but we will dry run the code and we will see how this is working. And if this condition is not satisfied, that is the character at I and the character at j are both equal and j is also greater than or equal to 0, then we will just increment I and j, and what we will do is just store the value of j in the ith index. So we will store the value of j in the ith index and we will close the loop. So this is the logic. This is the logic for preparing the reset table. Okay, so now let us just dry run this logic in our current example. So here you can see initially the value of j is equal to minus 1 and the value of I is equals to 0. So we will come in the loop and we will see, is I less than the pattern length? So here you can see the pattern length is 7. Okay, so now is 0 less than 7? Definitely 0 is less than 7. Then we will check if j is greater than or equal to 0. But here you can see j is less than 0. So this loop will not be executed. And then we will just increment the value of I and increment the value of j. So just increment the value of I. So I will now be pointing to here. So I is equals to 1 and now j is equals to 0. And then what we will do is just set the value of j at the ith index. So now the value of j is 0. So we will store a 0 here. Okay. Now, again, we will check, is I less than pattern length? Yes, it is. And then we will check if j is greater than or equal to 0. Yes, j is greater than 0. J is equal to 0. And we will also check the condition that if the character at the ith index is equal to the character at the jth index. So here you can see a is not equal to b. So we will what we will do is just reset the value of j equal to this value stored at the jth index. So the value stored at the jth index is minus 1. So now j will be again pointing to the value minus 1. Okay. Now what we will do is just increment the value of I and j again. So the value of j, I will be incremented as well as the value of j. So now j is again pointing here and I is pointing here. Okay. And now we will store the value of j at the ith index. So again a 0. Then again the loop will be executed. We will check if j is greater than or equal to 0. Yes, it is. And we will check if the character at the ith index is equal to the character of j of at the jth index or not. And here you can see the characters are not equal. So what we will do? Again, set the value of j equal to the value stored at the jth index. So that will be minus 1. So j is equals to minus 1 again. And now what we will do? Again, increment the value of j and I. So now j is again pointing here and I is pointing here. We will store the value of j at the ith index. So now the value of j is 0. And again, the loop will be executed and we will see if j is greater than equal to 0 or not. So here j is equal to 0 and also the character at the ith index is not equal to the character at jth index because x is not equal to a. So what we will do is again reset the value of j as minus 1. So here you can see j will be reset to minus 1. So j will be resetted to minus 1. Okay. So now we will increment the value of I and j again. So value of I and j will be incremented. So j is pointing here and I is pointing here. And we will store the value of j at the ith index. So the value of j is 0. So we will store 0. Okay. Now again the loop will be executed and we will come to the checkpoint. And here you can see j is greater than or equal to 0. But the character at the ith index is equal to the character at jth index, because I is pointing to A and J is also pointing to A. Okay, so what we will do is not execute this loop and we will just increment the value of I and J. So the I and J values will be incremented. So J will be pointing here and I will be pointing here. Okay. So now what we will do is just store the value of J at the ith index. So the value of J is 1. Okay. So now the loop will be again executed and we will see if J is greater than or equal to 0. Definitely it is. And the character at the ith index is again equal to the character at the jth index. So what we will do is just increment the value of I and J. We will be incrementing the value of I and J. So J will be pointing here and I will be pointing here. And now what we will do is just store the value of J at the ith index. So value of J is 2. So we will store 2 here. Okay. So here you can see the loop has been exhausted completely, because if we again execute the following loop and we will see if J is greater than equal to greater than or equal to 0 or not. So J is greater than equal to 0 and the character at the ith index and the jth index is not equal. So we will reset the value of J as reset at J. So the value at the second index is equal to 0. So J will be reset to value 0. So J will be pointing here and we will increment I and J and again reset the value of store the value at the ith index equal to J. So incrementing the values, J will be pointing here and I will be pointing here. So I will be pointing outside the array and the loop will be exhausted. So here you can see we have completed our reset table. So what the reset table is showing us is, here you can see for the first index, that is the 0th index, there is no prefix that is present as a suffix also, because for every single character string the prefix and suffix are always equal, so no point of considering that. But if we consider the string as AB, then also there is no suffix that is present as a prefix. Then we will consider a string ABC. Here also there is no suffix which is present as a prefix, so again we will consider a larger string. So here you can see there is no suffix present as a prefix in the string, so again we will consider a larger string. So here you can see in this string there is a suffix of length 1, that is A, which is equal to the prefix of the given pattern. So here you can see we have stored 0 because there might be a chance that this will be corresponding to this element. And now we will again increment the size of the substring that we are considering. So here you can see we have a suffix that is AB, which is also present as a prefix AB. So here we are storing 1 because this 1 denotes the last index. This denotes the last index of the prefix matched with the suffix. Okay, so here you can see the last index of AB on the prefix side was 1, so we are storing 1 here. And now here you can see if we are considering a larger string, that is this one, so here you can see there is no suffix which is present as a prefix also. But then you will ask that why we have stored 2 here, because 2 is pointing to this position. So whenever we will be executing our loop in the matching algorithm, then we will be seeing that what should be the value of J. So in the matching algorithm we will put a similar check like this one. So in the matching algorithm what we will do is check while J is greater than or equal to 0 and the character at the ith index of the string, that is str at I, is not equal to pattern at J. And if this condition holds true, then what we will do is just reset the value of J is equals to reset of J. Okay, so now what will happen is we will check if any point in the string we have a character X, which is we are pointing to the character X, and then we will see if the character at the ith index of the string is equal to the character at the ith index of the jth index of the pattern, and suppose we got a mismatch. So what we will do is just update the value of j is equals to reset at j. So the value of j is equals to reset at j. So what is the value of currently j? That is 2. So j is equals to reset at 2. And now what is the value of reset at 2? That is 0. So j will be pointing to 0. So here you can see j is pointed here. So now let us just dry run the matching algorithm also, and then we will get a better understanding on how this KMP reset table is working for us. So let me just rub this. Okay. So now what we will do is just start our matching. So let us just start the matching. Just dry run our code, and what we will do is just initialize the value of I and J both equal to 0. So both of them will be pointing to the 0th character of the string and the pattern. And at every iteration, what we will do is just follow the following logic, that if the value of j is equal to 0 and both the pointers are not pointing to the same character, then we will reset the value of j. Else, what we will do is just increment the value of I and j if the following check is not executed. So if the following check is executed, then also after the check, we will be incrementing the values, and if the values are not executed, if the check is not executed, then we will just increment the value of I and J and no resetting will happen. So let us just dry run the code and you will get a better gist on how the algorithm is working. So here you can see I and J are both pointing to the same character. So what we will do is just increment the value of both I and J. So I is pointing here and J is pointing here. So here you can see again, the value of the character at both I and J are equal. So we will again increment the value of I and J. But now here you can see I is pointing to a character A and J is pointing to a character C. So here you can see J is greater than or equal to 0, but the both the characters pointed by I and J are not equal. So we will just update the value of J is equals to reset at J. Okay. So I've just made a small mistake here. This is reset at J. Okay. So if the value will be of J will be equal to reset at J, currently the value of J is 2. So J is equals to reset at 2. So the value of reset at 2 is equal to 0. So now J will be pointing to 0. So here you can see we will update the value of J and J will be pointing to 0. So now J is pointing here. Okay. So now what we will do is just increment the value of both I and J. So now I will be pointing here and J is here. J will be here and I will be here. Okay. So now here you can see both the characters are still not equal. So what we will do is just reset the value of J from the reset table. So J is equals to reset at J. So reset at J, that is reset at 1 is equals to 0. So J is again pointing to 0. Now again we will increment the value of both I and J. So now I will be pointing here and J will be pointing here. Now here you can see both the characters are same, so we will just increment the value of both I and J. So now I is pointing here and J is pointing here. Here also the characters are same, so again we will increment the values. So now I is pointing here and J is pointing here. Again the values are same, so we will just increment the value of I. So I will be pointing here, J will be pointing here, and again the characters are same. Then I will be pointing here and J will be pointing here. Okay, so this will be our current situation. Now as both the characters are again same, so we will just increment the value of both I and J. So I and J both will be incremented. So now I is pointing here and J is pointing here. So now what we will do is J is greater than or equal to 0, but the characters are not same. So we will just reset the value of J as J is equals to reset of J. So the value of J is currently 6. So J is equals to reset at 6. So the value of reset at 6 is equal to 2. So what we will do is just update the value as reset at 2, reset at 6. So now J will be pointing here. So now after the check, we will just increment the value of both I and J. So Here you can see I will be pointing here and J will be pointing here. So this is the point where you will find the KMP algorithm as the most superior algorithm in the pattern matching. Because in the brute force approach, when C and X were not matching, what we were doing is just going way back here, and from here to here, and then again restarting the whole algorithm. That is, when the I pointer was pointing to C and J pointer was pointing to X, in the brute force algorithm, we were updating J as 0 and updating the value of I as the next value which it was pointing to. So initially it was pointing to A, then I will be pointing to B, and again we were going to increment the loop. Then B and A were not matching, so I will be pointing to C. Then again C and A doesn't match, so again I will be pointing to X, again a mismatch. Then I will be pointing to A, so again I will be pointing to A, so A and A will match. Then I will be pointing to B and J will be pointing to B. Then again B and B will match. Then again C and C will match, and we will again come to X. So here you can see we made almost 6 more iterations when we encountered a mismatch at C in the brute force algorithm. But what we did in our KMP algorithm, whenever we got a mismatch, we checked the reset table. So here we got the mismatch and we checked the reset table and updated the value of J to here and then incremented the value of J and I. So currently I and J are pointing to these positions. And here you can see this is a suffix which is present as a prefix here. So this is a prefix and this is a suffix. So whenever there is a suffix which is also present as a prefix in the pattern, then we are not going to again revisit that suffix, right? So we are saving the iterations here. We are saving the iterations here because in the brute force, we were again revisiting whether the suffix is present as a prefix or not. But if at any index that we have explored now, we have a suffix which is present as a prefix in the pattern, then what we will do is just skip that part of the suffix because that is obviously going to be equal to the pattern, and we will check the remaining string with the rest of the pattern. So now I and J are incremented as below. So now what we will do is again check if I is pointing to the same character as J, then again they are pointing to the same character, then I and J both will be incremented, again they are pointing to same character, then I and J both will be incremented, and again they will be incremented, and here you can see we got a pattern, right? So what is the gist of the KMP algorithm? Anytime when we are iterating over our string, then we will check that if there is a suffix present as a prefix in the pattern, suffix in the given string present as a prefix in the pattern, and if we got a suffix that is present as a prefix, then there is no need to revisit that suffix. Because that is obviously going to be matched with the prefix and we will be just wasting our iterations. And how we managed to do so, we just prepared a reset table. So in the reset table, we have stored that at what index we have the longest prefix, which is also present as a suffix. So now, let us take one more example of a pattern and see how we are going to prepare the reset table for that pattern. Okay. So let us just take a new pattern. So the new pattern can be taken as A B. Okay. So let me just do one more and A. Right. So let us just take this pattern and prepare a reset table for the following pattern. Okay, so this will be our reset table and these characters will be matched as A, B, A, B, A, B. And the corresponding indexes are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So this will be our reset table. So to give a better clarity on how the reset table algorithm is working on and how the pre-processing of the KMP algorithm is working, let us just take another example. So now what we are going to do is just initialize the value of I with 0 and j with minus 1. So I will be equal to 0 and j will be equal to minus 1. So I will be pointing to here, and before initializing the value, what we will do is just store the value minus 1 as the 0th index. Now what we will do is again execute this algorithm as we have discussed earlier. So we are going to execute this algorithm. I run our code, and initially we will store the value minus 1 at the 0th index and initialize our variable I as 0 and j as minus 1. Now what we will do is just check if j is greater than or equal to 0 or not. So here you can see we will check j is greater than or equal to 0 or not. So j is not equal to 0, neither greater than 0. So we will just increment the value of both I and j. So we will increment the value of both I and j. So after incrementing the value of both I and j, we will store the value of j at the ith index, that is 0. And now we will check if both are pointing to same elements or not. So here you can see both are not pointing to same elements. So we will reset the value of j as reset at 0. So j will now be pointing to minus 1. Now again we will increment both the values, so again j will be pointing to 0 and I will be pointing to 2. I will be pointing to 2 and j will be pointing to 0. And now here you can see we will store the value of j at the ith index, that is 0. Now again we will check if both the characters, both the pointers are pointing to the same characters or not. So here you can see both are pointing to same characters. So we will not do any resetting and just increment the values. So j will be pointing to the first index and I will be pointing to the third index. And we will store the value of j at the ith index, that is 1. Now what we will do is just check if both are pointing to same characters or not. So here you can see both are not pointing to the same characters. So we will just reset the value of j as reset at 1. So reset at 1 is 0, so j will be pointing to 0. Now again we will check if both are pointing to the same characters. Yes, they are pointing to the same character. So we will exit out this check loop. So we will exit the check loop and we will just increment the value of both I and j. So if we increment the value of both I and j, so I will be pointing here and j will be pointing here. So now we will just store the value of j at ith index, that is 1. Now again we will check if both are pointing to same characters. Yes, they are. So we will just increment the values and store the value of j at the ith index, that is 2. And now we will again check if they are pointing to the same elements. Yes, they are. So we will again increment the value and j will be pointing here and I will be pointing here. Now again we will store the value of j at the ith index, and now we will check if both are pointing to the same character or not. So both are not pointing to the same character, so we will reset the value of j as reset at 3. Because the current value of j is 3, so j will become 1. So j will be pointed to 1. Now we will increment both the values. So j will be pointing to the second index and I will be pointing to the seventh index. Now we will store the value of j at the ith index, that is 2, and now we will check if they are pointing to the same elements, and no, they are not pointing to the same elements. So we will again reset the value of j. So now j will be equal to reset at 2, that is 0. So j will be pointing to the 0th index. Now again we will check if they are pointing to the same elements or not. So here you can see they are not pointing to the same elements. So we will again update the value of j as minus 1. Now we will increment both the values of I and j. So I and j both will be incremented. So j will be pointing to the 0th index and I will be pointing here. So we will store the value of j, that is 0, at the 8th index. Okay. So now we will check if they are pointing to the same elements. Yes, they are. So we will just increment the values. So now j is pointing here and I is pointing here. We will store the value of j at the ith index and again check if they are pointing to the same elements. And yes, they are pointing to the same element. So we will reach the end of the loop by our last iteration, and j will be pointing to second index and I will be pointing to the last index, and we will again store the value 2 here, and the loop will terminate. So here you can see we have again prepared our reset table. So what this reset table is saying, that suppose we are considering the whole string, then we have a suffix here which is also present as a prefix. Again, suppose we are considering the string up till here only. So again, what you can see is here you can see whenever we will be checking our string matching, then suppose we got a mismatch here. So what we will do is just reset the value of j. So resetting of the value of j will be equal to, so j will be pointing to the third index. So here you can see the value at the sixth index is 3, so now j will be pointing to the third index. And again, we will check if j and that character is matching to the same point or not. And suppose the both of them are matching, so here you can see we can see that we have a suffix that is a, that is also present as a prefix. So we will just start iterating from the next index. So this reset table is just giving you the length of a suffix which is also the index of a suffix which is also present as a prefix, the last index of the prefix. So I hope the logic for the reset table is clear to you all. You can see anytime, suppose in this string, suppose we are considering this string. So here you can see we only have one suffix as a prefix. If we are considering this string, then we have length of suffix 2, which is also present as a prefix. So just it is giving us the index at which the prefix is ending. So I hope the logic for the KMP algorithm is clear to you all. So the complexity of the KMP algorithm is big O of n plus m. How? Because in the string matching function, we will be iterating at max n times, and in the pre-processing function, we will be iterating at max big O of m time. So now what we will do is just add both the complexities and we will get big O of n plus m. So I hope the logic for the problem is clear to you all. In the next video, we are going to implement the KMP algorithm in C++ language. So just stay tuned to the channel of Coding Blocks, and I hope you all have got a good grasp on how the KMP algorithm is working. So just comment down your doubts in case you have any, and we will see the implementation of this code in the next video. So thank you guys. See you next time.